Thank you for tuning in to the UC San Diego Mi Camino Student Series. Today we're talking with Ronny Vasquez. Ronny is a transfer student originally from Venezuela who studies chemical engineering and works for CREATE, the Center for Research on Educational Equity, Assessment, and Teaching Excellence. Thank you for being here today, Ronny.
Thank you, Frank. I'm very happy to be here too.
So let's talk a little bit about your experience as a transfer student. Tell us a little bit about how you found yourself in the United States and how you found yourself in community college.
Well, when I came here, it was a cultural shock, you know, being from a Latin American country where we're very warm as people. We like to give hugs. It was a very sensitive change when I came here, and everything was, everyone was doing their own thing. So there was that sense of belonging when I started my studies here in the United States. But then I found people that I could rely on when I transferred to UCSD. My team, my peers, they helped me through, you know, getting that change that you need, that confidence that you need in order to succeed in your classes with their help and friendship.
So you talked a little bit about finding your peers and your community. Where exactly did you find that community at?
It was when I started my first year as a transfer in UC San Diego. The first 2 weeks were rough since I didn't know what to expect from the university. Then I started going to TA session, office hours, and I would see the same people every time, and I would start talking to them. And then I realized that we had the same struggles. So we started bonding. We started creating study groups. We started sharing the same hobbies. So we bonded that in that way through you know, our struggles.
And how is it that you came to choose UC San Diego as the university that you wanted to transfer into?
Well, before coming, before going to UC San Diego, I actually went to San Diego City College. I actually came to San Diego to study English. I did not speak any English when I came to the United States. I studied English for 6 months. I was able to speak it fluently. I did a month of preparation to get into San Diego City College. And because I was already familiar with the city, since I was studying English here, UC San Diego was the first choice, since they also offer chemical engineering. And I decided to stay and take the opportunity.
Now, you're from Venezuela. How is it that you found yourself in the United States?
I have a very supportive family. My uncle and my aunt, they actually live here in the United States. My uncle, he's a chemical engineer, and he has been supporting me through my academic journey. So it's been a blessing having him in the family and having all the family supporting me in Venezuela and here as well.
Now, you did mention a little bit earlier that it was a bit of a culture shock for you to come to the United States and to be in community college here. And I imagine going from a community college to a four-year institution was also a bit of a culture shock. What tips did you learn in community college that helped you navigate that culture shock?
Yes. So the first thing that I'm going to say, I learned the concept of self-advocacy, just fight for yourself. It's been something that had been in my mind since I started college. Since this cultural shock, I knew that I had to excel by myself, even though I didn't know how to. I wanted to find ways for myself to improve and get better. So I would say apply that self-advocacy, since it's going to help you through many challenges in the educational path. Yes.
So can you give us an example of what self-advocacy is? So just give us a really concrete example so that the people that are listening can get a good feel for what that is.
Of course. So when I transferred to UCSD, the size of the classrooms changed as well. So I was used to a community college size of classroom where 30 to 40 people was a full room. When I transferred to UCSD, it was an auditorium, more than 100 people in one classroom. So that was that's intimidating, right? But sometimes you in class, you don't understand everything what the professor says. So you gotta fight for yourself and ask that question in front of everyone, maybe thinking that it's a dumb question, right? That's the usual thinking when you transfer to a big classroom like that. But then you gotta fight for yourself. You gotta ask that question because the question is for you. It's not for the ones that around you. You wanna make sure that you understand the material that you learn and that you can apply later.
Now, when you and I first talked, you mentioned that you sat in the front row. Is that correct?
That is correct. Yes, that was my target. Every time I got into classroom, I would sit in the front row. It was easier once the second week was already passed because everyone would just sit in the same row. So I'll always shoot for the first one.
Now, why did you do that? Why did you aim for sitting in the front row?
I learned that it's a learning strategy just to make sure that sitting in the front would just keep you away from the distractions to only look at the board and the professor. So that's what I did. I followed that rule.
Now, in four-year universities, the professors have something that's called office hours. And I'm wondering if you took advantage of office hours.
Yes. So honestly, in the first year, I wanted to go to office hours and I did. But then the following years, I found, the support that I have, all my peers, my friends. So we would take turns, or even the people that wanted to go to office hours, they would go, and then we'll share the information, so be more time efficient in that sense. So the first year I would go to TA hours and office hours. Then the second year we realized that, we have this big family inside the major, so that we can just share information and be more efficient that way.
So the big family inside your major was other students like yourself who were studying chemical engineering?
Correct. Yeah, we're a big group and we're very happy that we all chose this major together.
Now, our engineering school has what's called the Ideal Center. Did you participate in any of the Ideal Center activities or programs?
Yes. So the Ideal Center, actually, there are several activities that were required to go, as a 3D printer and how to learn how to use that. And so it was a class, part of a class that I have fun. I would like to be more active in that sense, but classwork gets very heavy on my end.
Now let's talk a little bit about Create, because we learned about you through your work at Create. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about what Create is and what was your role with them?
Yes, so for Create, I'm a STEM outreach ambassador. I mostly teach K through 12 students. I go to middle schools. I perform wet and dry labs. We have fun with the kids. I prepare them to their science competitions. We also do some online lessons that we have in our YouTube channel, Create at UC San Diego. There we have the opportunity with all the online platforms right now that, because of the pandemic, has been developing, where we have the opportunity to go to each kid's home and provide this lesson that we're not able to anymore.
So what is it that you learned in teaching these classes to K through 12 students here in San Diego?
It's very challenging because we usually have all these kids mixed together in the same classroom. So you gotta understand that the age different, the vocabulary also changes. So you gotta make sure that you keep the small kids entertained while you actually give something meaningful to the bigger kids so that they can take home and be inspired by science.
And so if you were talking to, let's say, someone in the 10th grade or 9th grade, what advice would you give them about preparing for a university education?
So they might feel that they don't know what to do yet, but I encourage them to explore their opportunities, be proactive, make sure that you analyze all the opportunities and majors that are there. Maybe STEM is not for them, but to try them. Try it first in order to see if they like it or not.
And let's talk a little bit about student life. So you're a transfer student. Did you live at home with your uncle and aunt, or did you live on campus?
I live at home with my uncle and my aunt, yes.
So you were commuting every day?
I'll be commuting an hour, from downtown to La Jolla. So I would take I'll have to walk about 10 minutes, then take the bus, and then it'll be a 1 hour commuting from downtown to La Jolla. It actually gave me time, to read and study in the meantime. So I would take the most of it.
And university can also be very fun. It's not always about studying, right? So maybe you can share with our listeners some of the fun things that you did and experienced because of your time here at UC San Diego.
Of course, yeah. So we're a big group. We like to do different things, but mostly our hangouts are when we study. That's where all the good moments come from. Outside of the university, I have some friends that they like to play sports. Volleyball is a big one for me. I have friends that they are very good at that sport. So I would just go with them and play. Also, food. We're big on food. We like to try different types of food. So the Cent major, it's very diverse. So I would just try food from different, friends that would recommend some different types of food. And then I would go and try them. So it's a nice food hopping hobby that we have.
Now, earlier you said that, you found these friends in your engineering major and that one thing that bonded you was that you had similar experiences. What did you mean by that?
I think the change from a community college to a four-year university, how everything was really fast, that you had to get into homework, exams, right on the second week, you need to start studying the first week. I think we all struggle in that transition. That's how we started bonding. Then homework became very time consuming. So we had to maximize our time. So we would just distribute, as I mentioned before, office hours, TA hours, and then make sure that we all come together and share the information.
So you were working as a collective of scholars to support each other.
Yes. We were a big chain that without them, I wouldn't be where I am right now.
Now, for the United States, that's a little bit of a different attitude, I think, towards being in university. The United States tends to be very individualistic, right? So every student is out for themselves. But it sounds like that's not the case, at least for you, and maybe not even at UC San Diego, that there are students who want a more collective approach to studying and supporting each other, gathering information. So it sounds like that was your experience. Is that true?
Yes, that is correct. I've been very lucky. It wasn't the same at a community college. My group was very reduced. But now, since I transferred, I think it's been more collective. So my group has expanded and it's made it way easier for me, yes.
That's great. So would you recommend to incoming students that they try to find a study group that's got a more collective approach?
100% recommended. Yes, if I were to, if someone were to ask me what would I do, since day one, I would say make friends. It took me 2 weeks to start doing that, so it was kind of rough. 2 weeks in a quarter system is kind of like very fast. So yeah, since day one, I started networking, meeting people, meeting the professors, so that in the future, the struggle is not as hard.
And so you're graduating soon, correct?
I am, yes.
And so you're going to be going to graduation. And so what are your plans after graduation?
So my plans after graduation, I would like to go into the industry, part of my major. I would like to work into the water treatment industry. But I'm honestly open to anything since my major is so much, there is so much to explore around.
And I imagine you're feeling very proud and looking forward to your graduation. Will you be having some family with you?
Yes. I'm very proud. Finally, the notice that it was in person made me feel really good. It's going to be the first graduation after this in person, after this pandemic. So it's going to be memorable. I'll have some family over. And yes, all the friends were ready to take pictures and, you know, make the best of the memories.
Now, kind of getting back to some good tips for students who are coming in, I know that one of them is to find mentors who can, who've come before you, can help kind of guide you through that process. Were you able to find some mentors?
Yes, yes. So I actually had the opportunity to do an internship in 2018 at UC San Diego. They assign you a mentor, but the relationship that I have with this mentor is it's very personal. We connected very good. He's been a support throughout my education. He used to be a postdoc at UCSD. Now he's a principal investigator in the University of Brigham, New York. So he's been growing since then, and I've been growing as well since I'm going to be graduating. So we always keep in contact. He's always giving me advices on how to navigate the campus services, how to succeed in my classes. And someone else that I also consider my mentor will be my boss at Create, Beto. So he's, you know, sometimes bosses are not considered as mentor, but for him, he's been a different experience. He's always making sure that I feel good, that I learn, that I feel comfortable in front of the camera, in front of the kids, learning and trying to pass that knowledge to other generations as well.
That's great. And so what advice would you give to incoming first year students? And then also what advice would you give to incoming transfer students?
To new students, same thing. And for transfers as well, make sure that you connect, make sure that you feel that you belong, that you create a group that supports you throughout the major, because it is very important. It is very important to feel supported. Mostly if your family is not in town, I think you'll need a network or friends that can support you throughout the major, even though if it's not the same major that you're pursuing, but find someone that can support you and give you that push that you need in order to keep going.
And to end our time together, I would love for you to share maybe one or two of your fondest moments while you were here at UC San Diego.
Yes, so the most memorable one was that, as I mentioned before, in the chemical engineering department, we're a very good group, a big group. And one time we actually took over the library, we'll call it, took over the library. We were like about 15 to 20 people. We just took around some tables, put it in the middle of the library, and it was great. It was the first time I think that people just put tables around the library like that. And we just were working together in projects. So it was, people would look at us, oh, there's the chemical engineering people working together. So it was a very fun and memorable time.
Sounds like it was a really great bonding activity and a friendship development activity.
It was. We had fun, and all these people are graduating with me. So the ones that I started with are graduating with me. We're very happy that we are collectively moved on. And we're just waiting for the next step.
Great. Any closing comments you'd like to share with our audience before we end our time?
Good luck. Make sure that you feel like you belong, that you like what you're doing. It's very important that you like what you're doing. If you feel that you can do it, do it. If not, challenge yourself. Practice a self-advocacy. And make sure that you're following your dreams.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Ronny, for being with us today.
Thank you, Frank. I appreciate it.